Assalamu alaikum and hello to everyone. In this tutorial video, we are going to explore how to add a state diagram into our drawing area. First of all, I'm going to remove this description and replace it by a state diagram. Go to Insert menu, select State Diagram and insert one. And we can actually resize this by dragging the edge and insert a second one. We can actually just use one single state diagram, but we can also do it by using two. So once we have the state diagram in our drawing area, we need to identify the components which we want to analyze. First of all, I'm going to designate the top one for pneumatic components and the bottom one for electrical components. So pneumatics, I'm going to insert my control valve first, and then the way to insert it was click and hold the component and then drag it all the way to the state diagram and then just release the mouse button. So the first dragging action takes it in, the second one removes it. So it is as simple as that. Drag and insert, drag and remove. Okay, so I'm going to insert my control valve first and then followed by the cylinder, or perhaps the other way around. I should insert my cylinder first so that my cylinder becomes at the top and then my control valve. So the cylinder is at the top and then the control valve at the bottom. Likewise, we are going to insert the electrical switches into our state diagram. So I'm going to start with my switch number one, followed by switch number two, and I'm not going to insert the relay contact, although you can. And solenoids are not draggables. You cannot use them to be analyzed in the state diagram. Neither relays. So relays and solenoids are not analyzed by the state diagram. However, if you have a buzzer or a lamp, you can actually drag that in. So we have now our two push buttons and the buzzer, which is the output of the electrical circuit. And now I'm going to run the simulation, and you can see when I switch on the start button, so those components connected are going to go high. Start button, so you can actually see the switch one going high and the rest also going high. Okay, so I'm going to switch off my simulation. And then why am I seeing a vacant designation for my double acting cylinder as well as my control valve? Because there is no label. So we are going to insert a label here. Insert a label here, and that would be 1V1. S, okay, I'm going to do that in capital letter. Once you insert a label, you can actually see the reflection in your state diagram. And if you take that text far away, you'll see that the designation also disappears. So you should place it near your component. And you can just copy and paste it here for your actuator. So I'm going to put 1A for actuator, and another one I'm going to copy this and paste it over here for my buzzer. So my buzzer should be H1. So now I have all of my components with their descriptions as well as the designation. So that's it for this tutorial, how to set up your state diagram. I hope that this was helpful. Thank you and see you again.